In this video, we will write a script which renames all the files inside the files directory. Specifically, we will add a prefix to all these files. So, by the end of this video, these files will have been renamed to something like new-abc.txt, new-def.txt, etc. If you follow the previous video, and you should have done that, then you know that we will be using pathlib, specifically the path class of pathlib. So how do you go about implementing this? How do we rename all these files? Well, whenever you have to manipulate files or directories, change them, rename them, copy them, delete them, first you want to determine where these files are, in what folder, what is the root directory. So in our case, what is the root directory? Well, our files are inside this files directory. Therefore, the root directory, which is a variable that I'll create, is path. So I'm creating a path object instance with files as a string. So with that, now I have the files directory as a path object. And I can go further and create a list of file paths using root dir dot iter dir method with parentheses. And just to demonstrate you what we have this far, I'm going to convert this file paths generator into a list, because you know that from the previous video that this method outputs a generator. So list file paths, and let's see what we have. Yeah, so we have this list of all the files that we want to rename. Right, three files. So I can go ahead and delete that print function. And then guess what should we do now? Well, you guessed it, it's a for loop. So for path in file paths. So we will go through each of these three file paths, the first one, the second one, and so on. And what do we want to do in each iteration? So our goal again is to rename each of these files. Therefore, I think we should first think of a new name. So to construct a string to represent the name as a string, and then we construct a path that points to that new file name, to that new file, actually. So a file, for example, this file is a file on disk, and in Python, this file is represented through a path, file path, and this path object is represented through a string. So there's a chain of objects, right? So the new file name is going to be new dash plus path dot stem plus path dot suffix. Let's print file name, new file name, to just see what we have. Run, and yeah, this is what I intended to have as the new file names, but of course, don't expect these to be changed by now, because we didn't manipulate any paths, right? We're simply iterating here, constructing a string, and then we need to do something with that string. So let's delete, print. The way this works, I think it's clear. So we have a string, new path.stem gives you only the file name without the extension, so abc. So we have new-abc.txt. This gives you the extension of the file name for each file. Right, so we said now we need a path or file path, whatever you like to call it. So I tend to name the variables that point to path objects using paths at the end. So paths here or path here. And you see here, this is a string, so I named it differently. So new file path, we said it is a path object, right? And the argument is the string. So path classes get string as arguments, right? In this case, it's new file name. But we need to add something else here. So it's not exactly new file name. This will cause us some problems, and I want to show you this problem now so that you learn a very important point related to manipulating files and folders. Because see what happens now if I try to rename the path. So path is this one in here, which means it is the current path of the loop. So one of those here. And if I rename that path by giving it the new path as argument, so rename is a method of a path object, and it gets another path object as output. If I run this script now, you're going to see some maybe strange outputs, but it has an explanation. So what happened is that the files are not inside files anymore. You see, files is empty. If I collapse the folder, these files now are outside the files path. They are in the main repo directory, not inside files. So what happens is that this new file path, what it is this. I'll print it for you. Print new file path. Run. No output because now files is empty, but let me drag them inside files again as they were before and run the script without renaming. So run. This is the output we get from printing out the file path. But because the current working directory is set to the repo directory and not to the files directory, these files are written in that repo directory. So the current working directory. You'll see that if I print out print path.cwd and call that method and run. This is the current working directory where Python is working on at the moment in this script. And that means this new path will be appended to that working directory. So the complete path of this new file path will be something like home runner rename all files to slash new abc.txt. That's why we see those files written in the main directory, which is rename all files to. To change that, you need to follow a different approach. So instead of doing this here, we point to the existing path dot with name, and the name is new file name. If I run this script now without executing rename just yet, if I run this time we'll see files is appended before these. Therefore, this file name now, this file path will be appended to this, and therefore we're going to see the correct output. So a new text is added to the existing ones. Right, just to be clear, I'll rename this to the original ones, like that, and uncomment the rename method. So new file name here, new file path in here, new file path in rename, and run. And these are the three renamed files. And this is the correct output. So that was about this video. There are a few key points to take from this video. So the first one was that you want to work with path objects. So if you have a string that represents a file path in disk, then you need to create a path object type using that string. And then be careful with current working directory. The current working directory is always where your main.py file is located. And main.py file is located in this directory. Therefore, if you want to write new files or rename files, you want to make sure that the new file path that you are renaming has the correct path. And in our case, the correct path was files/new-abc.txt and so on for the other files. And we did the trick with this part here. So path with name, that means that we created a new path here from the existing path, but with a new name. So basically this says, give me that path with a new name for the file part. And we set a new name in here. And then we renamed the existing path, giving that new name. I hope that is clear, and I'll talk to you later. Thank you.